Welcome back, viewers, to another episode of This Is Persia. So, it's happened. We've declared war on the Ottomans once again because they got themselves into a war with the unknown European powers of Hungary and Austria, who are pretty big players in this game. Hungary's over here, Austria's over here, because we totally know that. So, we're taking advantage of this. I have one army over here. How much army do they actually have? I probably should have checked this first. They actually have a pretty damn big army. That said, if we combine all our troops, we have a bigger army. Problem is, half army's down here. Speaking of half the army, yep, so there's some troops over there. This army's trying to head back up here, but for now, this should be good enough. This is 0421. Let's put you in charge. You're the better general. And let's go take ISO. We can't get to any other force until we take... Oh, we can get this one straight away. That makes no sense whatsoever. Are you telling me I can just completely ignore this fort? Say what? Okay, ignoring that. Go take ISO, then we'll go take this, and then we'll go take this. I think that might be the plan. I do have to take Ankara at some point, though. But I want to take ISO first to be safer. In fact, I could be really ambitious here and try to take both at the same time because the Ottomans are probably very distracted. But it's definitely safer if I don't do that. So go take this, and I'll have the other army meet up. This fight here will finish soon enough. What's this? Royal marriage from the Uzbeks. Go away. Military access from Oman. Sure, Oman. Oman has accepted peace. Yemen will be forced to give 10% of income and 52 ducats. Those were my ducats. Damn it, Oman. Oh well, that's okay. I think what I'm going to do here is I'm going to transfer most of these to Najid, who are our new vassal. Najid is totally... Oh, they're totally rebellious. That's annoying. That's actually slightly annoying. I might spend prestige to try to buy them back down. Or something, I don't know. I'm trying to improve relations with them. That might help a little bit. Let's make sure Oman likes us. So I'm going to improve relations with you. And I've got to make sure Mamluks doesn't end up hating me. Oh, which they shouldn't. We have plus 42 with them. I should be able to take a decent chunk out of the Ottoman without them caring too much. That said, they are both Sunni. And that's actually something I learned recently. Apparently, if you take land from Sunni, other Sunni won't be too happy. But if you take land from Shia, which is why Persia was so great, the Sunni won't really even care, while Shia people will care, which are basically non-existent. I may have mentioned this last episode, but anyway, carry on. Just have CJ Fort back down, or just down. Oman, okay. Okay, sure. Let's go make sure these vassals are happy. We'll integrate them at some point, eventually. That was definitely a mistake. I should not have forced them to become Shia. I mean, it's great that they helped me convert these provinces. Right? Nope, this one's still Coptic. You're not even trying to convert it. Okay, how about you? Well, you are trying to help convert them. You'll succeed eventually. Basically, they're struggling with the same problem that I was struggling with, which is trying to convert these damn provinces. Oh, hi. Crimea, what the hell are you doing here? Ah, stupid Crimea. Okay, Uzbeks declare war on Timurids, trouble feud. Timurids. Sure, Uzbek. Be strong. Let's put a lead in charge here. 042, 141. Let's take the 042, I think. They're going for our fort at Sinope, that's good. Great Horde is giving us 10 ducats, which we have no intention of repaying. Sure, I'll take that. Okay. You're sieging my fort down. Good for you. What's this? Military access from Hungary. Who are you, Hungary? And why are you asking for military access? This is hilarious. Hungary's requesting military access despite the fact that I know nothing about them. Sure, I'll accept that. You're welcome to walk through my lands all you like. In fact, if you can kill all the Ottoman armies, that'd be great too. I mean, oh, did the army get bigger? Maybe. Ottomans, 28,000. Crimea, 6,000. Theodoro, 3,000. Well, that's an entire Crimean army right there. Which I better go obliterate with this army, and afterwards I might go to Ankara. What's this? Royal marriage from Oman? Nope. Coast has been raided by the knights. Yeah, unlike the Ottomans, I think I will try to get rid of the knights early on, because otherwise it's just going to annoy me a lot. Because they get to raid coasts. Okay, don't care. What I do care about though is that 5k. I'm going to take a few horsemen over here. Well, let's say take a few infantry. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'll take one horse. Move up here. And you move over here. We'll meet up and we'll go smash their faces in. And in the meantime, Hungary is having some fun over here. Edirne is being sieged down. Constantinople is not quite here because they have sieged on Edirne first. That's fine by me. They have boats. Well, fancy them. Ming has accepted peace with Jianzhou. Why peace? Sure. I don't actually care about what's happening over there. I don't actually want them to get on the boat, so let's go kill them. Okay, good. They don't actually get on the boat yet. Let's go kill them. 12k. We can do this. It's flat land. At least we should be able to do it. 16k versus 12k on flat land. Let's try do a better fight. I mean, what's the general? 220. Okay, let's go ahead. We have one maneuver. Two maneuver even. In fact, we can put the other general in charge. I mean, what is this? Land treasure minus 3%. Let's put this general in charge. This general is slightly better. We only need one movement to ignore that river. Oh, yes. Army is attack. Yes, it is. We're doing okay. I'd say that went pretty well. We lost a few, and they lost a lot more. Chase them down. No, let's just go to Ankara. I'm not sure where they're trying to retreat to. If I'm lucky, they'll retreat across the river. I mean, across the straits, but I don't think they're allowed to anymore. I think the straits are blocked now. Well, maybe not. I mean, usually Ottomans retain control of the seas because Ottomans are really good with their galleys. I haven't checked their ideas, but I think they have some pretty good ideas for galley combat. Hey, what is this? Ottomans, get out of my land. Where are you going? Get in Sinope. Okay. I think we'll just have one main force over here and a secondary force running around killing all these small armies. I mean, it's actually a good thing as well because we get war score for it. I mean, look at that. 5 war score for just that one fight. That's kind of silly. Okay, you are going to Sinope. Let's go stand in Sinope and let him just walk into us and die. Oh, wow. This thing is still going on. Ming is having civil war. Have fun, Ming. This is annoying. I'm going to actually hire one mercenary so I can finish this. Oh, but that's so much money, though. And that goes over our force number, too. That's problematic. Worth it. Let's hire one mercenary. I can't be bothered otherwise. Okay. Yep, I know. 0.1 war score. And now, let's go to Ankara. Now, if the entire army shows up, that'll be bad for me, obviously. Edirne is no longer being sieged. Curious. That place is still being sieged. Conversion successful. Great. Let's convert more places. We now have 61% religious unity, which is good for us. Let's convert, let's say, Guria. No, not Guria. What am I looking at? Sarosa? I wish you could click on this and tell you. I mean, can you actually click on it? Nope, of course not. That'd be too useful. So, Sarosa. What kind of places this is Kurdish. Apparently Kurdish is in the same culture group as us. That's great. So we'll convert that. And hopefully these guys will send me more random small armies for me to kill. Yep, I know. Where are you going? Okay. Have fun there. Of course if I see an army show up, that'll be bad. Okay, 1k. Hello. I can't get to you, can I? I think I have to go around, so not easily. What's that Merc? Has the Merc appeared yet? Yes, it has. Okay, hopefully we can get the stupid siege done soon. And we need more manpower. We are negative 4,000 right now. And we're not going to get any more anytime soon either. What I can do is try and save some manpower. What's this? Peace offer from Yemen. Nope. What I can try to do is take all these horses out. And put them in Karaman. And also takes down the Karaman as well. And can loot the place as well, which is also good. Okay, and I can do something similar here as well. Take all the horses out here. They can go to Konya. Just as flat ground, which is great. Oh, apparently that's too much. Leave 2 horses behind. Is that going to be enough? Hopefully, diplomat insult. Let's try and make everyone happy. This event is really weird. I mean, either you gain a diplomat and soldiers are completely worthless because that's kind of a pointless castle's belly, or you make everyone of the same culture or something. I'm not even sure. In the same similar area anyway, make them slightly happier. Let's just do that. Mamluks, you don't love me. You still want to accept the alliance though. Of course you won't. Okay, that's over. Let's have this army head up here now. And I might actually look to this peace deal. I mean, are you guys happier now by any chance? 49, okay. I'm about to make you bigger. I hope you love me for it. So I believe I need a border with... Actually, do I need a border here? I don't think I do. So what if I transfer all of this to Najd? And just fed the entirety of Yemen to Najd? How would... Is that even... allowed? Let's see. Because I don't actually need a land border of anything here. I mean, except maybe here, so I can attack whoever's over here. What is that, actually? But I'm not too interested in expanding into Africa anyway. I mean, I guess it's a good to keep expansion routes open, I suppose. We'll see. First, let's give orders to Najd. I mean, oh wait, I don't want to do that, do I? I want to keep the non-three development provinces. I can burn them down. Which means these three. Okay, so I want to keep these three. So let's say, give this to me. Give this to me. Now, unfortunately, since I just started War of the Ottomans, I can't transfer it. Things until the war's over, but I can't do it like this. So you accept that, and you give me 33 ducats. I can sit on this for a little while, because I kind of want to not hold on to those, because all they'll do is give me overextension. I mean, I'll burn them down naturally, but I don't really want to hold on to them. Of course, the longer I hold them onto them, the higher chance to be a revolt down here, which will be annoying. But I'll just ignore that for now. Let's just sit on there for a while. How's the Ottoman army looking? It's getting bigger. Jesus. Ottomans are scary. Karakun has occupied Karaman. Yes, I have. Go occupy that. Just occupy all this land. Yep, I occupy Konya. Yes, I have. Thank you, I suppose. Speak the game a little bit. High, stack of four. And please, let some more troops over here. I'll be quite happy if you do. Now let's put our last leader over here in charge, because we may as well. Who knows, might come in handy. Karakun has occupied something. Great. And I might actually go to ditch a Merc, by the way. I completely forgot. Yep, taking a load, that's okay. Let's ditch this one Merc, because he costs us 0.58 ducats a month, which we simply cannot afford. As opposed to a normal infantry, which costs us 0.2 ducats a month. So it's more than twice as expensive. So the whole point of hiring an American is that I could actually hire a normal troop, but I just have to finish that siege off. Siege of ISO is over. Or however you're supposed to pronounce that, I have no idea. Let's go and siege this down. We can't get to Hindu Vindigar, so we can't go kill that army. Charity for the poor. Providing charity to those in need is one of the cornerstones of the Islamic faith, and many have called for us to better provide for the poor in Tabriz. Okay, Tabriz. Tabriz is our capital, okay? For a small sum, we can have bread delivered and handed out to those who are starving. Gain piety or lose piety? Or I can see it as lose prestige or lose money. Prestige is very useful right now. Money is also very useful right now. Prestige or money? I mean, what's the current looking at? 100. Let's lose prestige. Sucks, but I don't want to lose the money. We kind of need the money. Peace offer from Yemen. Until you get rebels down there, I'm not going to accept anything. Truth expire of temperance, that's okay. I'm not planning to do anything anyway. You go over there. Let's have this army stay here. You will follow. Hi, can we kill that? Don't think we'll get there in time. Hi, what are you doing? Okay, let's go squash this small army. Can we get there from here? No, we can't. Not if I go all the way. Oh, that's a big army. Shit. Everyone, regroup. There's a very big army coming right our way. I mean, they are shattering to Hindu Vindigar. Question is, will they come here and attack us? That's a big question. You two stay there for now. Okay, please. Okay, shit, they are coming this way. Okay, retreat. Retreat. Group up. If they're gonna come here to fight, I'm not going to fight them in Highlands. Okay, the knights are here to fight. They are leaving again. They see my army as too big. Good. Let's go back to Citadel. Actually, let's go back to ignore Ankara, because I really don't care about Ankara. Oh, you have to go that way, do you? So do you. That's annoying. Okay, keep siege down Ankara. This is going to be a very annoying fight, simply because I don't want to get into myself into unfavorable fights. Oh, yeah, that's the only way you can go, huh? Okay, let's focus on getting Ankara down then. I'm going to assume that the Ottomans will focus on trying to drive away the Europeans. Multan has declared war on Timurids. Poor you, Timurids. Almost feel sorry for you. Independence for somebody. Unaz something. Unaz. Wow. Una. Iza. Okay, I failed. Una. Iza. Down here. Of course you guys aren't happy. Independence, you say? Well, that's unfortunate, isn't it? How big is the army? 11k. I can't afford to deal with them right now. We have to deal with this. So let's go back to sieging this. I possibly moved off Ankara too hastily. Let's take all the horses off again. We have enough infantry here now. Put you in Konya. Timurids have accepted Kondatatari from... Wait, you guys are still alive? I thought Sin ate you. Okay, sure. I'm not sure why you got spat back out, but well, look at this, Hormuz is eating into Persia. Yes, finish off Persia. I mean, technically we're trying to become Persia, but that's not the point. Okay, I'm just really worried because there's such a big army out there. Oh, these straits aren't blocked. That's curious. Okay, what's this? Peace offer from Yemen. Do you have rebels yet? No, you don't. Ignore. I mean, that is a little cruel, I suppose. Okay, let's move out one bit. So, let's move you out of here. I mean, one good thing about taking provinces is that we get to have more or less forward scouts. Whoops. This inability to reinforce due to lack of manpower is kind of frustrating. Okay, there's a big army. Our coast is being raided. Okay, let's see which way they go. They're going away. Cool. If we ever see them come back over here, we have to be ready for it. This is going to be a slow war. But, I mean, yes, we need to get into some more fights, but at the same time, I don't want to get into even further manpower debt. If I can help it. A cheap fight is better. Okay, they're coming back here. Here, okay. Group up here. You can reinforce here or here. You can reinforce up. Cool. Okay, they're coming to here, sure. If they want to waste everyone's time, that's good for them. After all, they're kind of getting wasted back over there. Just making sure you are losing over there. What the hell, Ottomans? So you're at war with Venice, Corfu, and Naxos. You're at war with Hungary and Austria. You're at war with Genoa, Lithuania, and the Papal State. You're at war with Karakun, Armenia, Georgia, and Najid. Holy shit, Ottomans. Defender against Hungary, minus 62. Defend against Genoa in the Genoese Crusade. Defend against me in the Karakum Purge of the Ottoman Heresy. Defend against Venice in the Venetian Reconquest of Escondra. Oh, wow. Sorry, Ottomans, but looks like this campaign is not your campaign. That said, they are kind of like having an entire army parked here, which does not please me. Not one bit. Still no rebels down there. I have to keep checking, because if I see rebel pop up, I have to do something. Okay, you're heading down to where? You're heading down to Tech. Okay, here's what I might do, because from here you can go to ISO easily enough. I'm going to combine these two armies here and smash them in ISO. Now, don't give us a ticking war score. Just making sure, no rebels, cool. They're going to ISO. Oh, well, that's awkward. Okay, from there, where can they go to? They don't have military access here, do they? Nope, no military access. You're warned by the Ottomans, so you're not going to like the Ottomans. I don't want to find Karaman. What's the general like? 103 is pathetic. We can beat that general, no problem, in flat terrain. Oh, you can go this way. Okay, let's see if we can get a fine ISO. Is this our best general? Nope, our best general is stuck in there. That's okay. We're going to take a river crossing, going to ISO, but that's okay. Let's take this leader, because this leader has the land retrition minus 3%. Okay, you go to ISO. 22nd, actually, nope, let's put that leader in charge. They have more maneuver than us, which... No, they don't, they have zero maneuver. Never mind, these Ottoman leaders are terrible. Let's take this fight. We should be able to win this hands down. Our fortress under siege and ice. What? Oh yeah, there was a fortress here, wasn't there? Persian separatists has... Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Persian separatists from Hormuz. This is so ridiculous. Doesn't matter. Let's win this stupid war. We'll deal with those rebels. Look at these numbers. Flatland. Oh, revolt. Three separatists. Okay, that's okay. We'll let them rebel, because this is more important. And you're heading to where exactly? And now we should have a taking war score. 6 and 5. Cool. Okay, where are you running to? Rebels are crossing the border. Oh my god, there's two armies of them? From Hormuz? So what, you ate a bit of Persia and now you can't deal with their separatists? And now I've dealt with those separatists? This is so ridiculous. Why do I deal with your stupid separatists? I'm still gonna kill you, Hormuz. I'm still gonna kill you. Just so you know. Just so you're forewarned. Because that's ridiculous. I'm not dealing with freaking rebels. Okay. Gain core on Fajid and Yabrin. Great. I'm going to lose this to rebels. I'm going to lose all of that to rebels. Hopefully those rebels will go right back and go attack Hormuz. Because I can't deal with them right now. Which is annoying because they're going to give me years of separatism, aren't they? Separatism? Minus plus 11. As opposed to... plus 11. Wait, doesn't it? I'm confused, actually. Doesn't matter. It's still very frustrating. Armenia. Okay, recall you. Let's improve on Georgia. Just to make sure everyone is happy. We're one big happy family. I'm not going to be able to catch them. But we do have a taking war score. Okay. It's so annoying. I'm solving our rebels. And we have Shamari rebels. Okay, that's okay. We've got more important things happening. What's this? Yemen wants peace. No peace yet for you. Let's split this up. We don't need so many people here. Where are you heading, actually? Ooh, can I go there? Yes, I can. Let's go beat that army up again. Rebel successful. Okay, don't care. Let's go take this fight. Is it the same general as they had last time? 103, yep. Ottomans, if I was you, I would reroll that general. That general is so bad. 103, I mean, the only thing you can get worse than that. Is 103? Never mind, they do have maneuver. I must have been reading it wrong. Or was that a different general? I'm confused. Doesn't matter. They has lost, like, what is this? 9,000? 6,000 plus 1.2? Okay, like 8,000? And we lost 4,000. Well, maybe 5,000. So we actually lost quite a bit in that fight. But the point is, we killed more than we lost. And we have taken war score. So the Ottomans are getting smashed. Putting it lightly. They don't want to be in this fight for much longer. Constantinople is currently being sieged down. I think the reason they're staying here is because they can't actually retreat across the water. Because this is blocked. Yep, it's blocked. Which is kind of annoying because it means we have to deal with the army. Holy person has arrived. A person from a holy order has arrived in court today. Gain 5 piety, gain a level 2 theologian, sure. That will come in handy in the future. Yemen, how you doing? Yemen is fine. Ignore. I'm sorry, Yemen. This is kind of cruel of me. I should not be doing this to you. But I am. So just deal with it. All I can say. Unfortunately, I can't actually get to them until this is sieged down. Okay, cool. Let's go here. Confirm successful. Great. Religious unity is slowly going up. Let's go and convert Erzincan, which is, I believe, somewhere around here. You are Armenian with 3.3 unrest. Well, boo-hoo. We're going to be dealing with so much rebellion soon. If I were to piece you out right now, what can I take from you? Can't take that. Okay, you accept that. You won't accept Hindavudiga. I want more than just three provinces. That's the thing. So if I take those three, can I take Constantinople? That would be so amazing. That will cause a coalition from Dukadir and Ramazan, which are these two, I believe. Dukadir and Ramazan. Well, if I don't take Constantinople, this Persia. I don't care about Persia. Ottomans, by the time our truce is over, Ottomans won't matter there. But I need how much more war score? Quite a bit, apparently. Whereas if I take this, you'll just straight up say no because I don't hold Constantinople. Okay, let's take some of this land then. Dukadir Ramazan. Is that such a big deal, these two join a coalition against me? I don't think it is. You know what? I'm going to preemptively improve relations with you two. And I do need to deal with those rebels. Because I'm about to get so much rebellion in my lands. It would be ridiculous. This is going to be bad. Rebel successful, I know. I know. I'm still frustrated as freaking rebels cross the border just into my lands. That part's really annoying. And I'm still bleeding cash. Persian rebels, yep, I know. God damn Hamuz, you guys suck. You should just not take any Persian land, then we won't have this stupid problem. Okay. Unfortunately, with this army here, I can't really move either of these armies anywhere else. I can't go siege that down. I mean, this is such a good opportunity to break the Ottomans. My problem is, I don't know if I can afford to do this. Okay, how about this? I take... Okay, the current army I have here is enough to deal with that Ottoman army, if they decide to do anything stupid. Ottomans, do you have any manpower left? Ottomans has 476 manpower, which is more than we do. Wow, we've lost 14,000. Here's what I'm going to do. Okay, I'm going to move this army here, and I'm going to move this army back, see what Ottomans do. They're moving to Bolu, okay. And then I'm going to have these two armies. Okay, we have one army go back and smash these stupid rebels. I'm going to give you some help. Because I think, oh, you're coming to my lands. Whoa, okay, where are you gonna take Sinope? Nope, you're just going back and forth. Okay, so I'm going to leave behind three horses. These three horses will go with this army, whereas you guys will go here. This army will come back here and deal with these stupid rebels. Let's start with these guys. We'll see. Just start heading back. Okay, nope. We're good, Yemen. Just keep hanging there. You'll be fine. Meanwhile, accept a peace, okay. Revolt, Ottoman separatists in that place. That's actually really annoying. And we have an actual Ottoman army. Okay, come back. I want to see where that Ottoman army goes. Hopefully they go to ISO. Okay, this siege is done. I don't really want to fight in the hills. Ottomans, if I repeat you out now, what will you give me? Okay, what if I don't take all this land? And give me some money. You're not happy. Okay. You only give me 30 ducats if I take all this. Do I want to just let them keep this land? I mean, they're about to get wasted anyway. I mean, look at that. They're on such low war enthusiasm. They don't want to be in this war. Okay, I'll keep these two armies around. Okay, how about this? I'll ignore them for now. I need to kill these rebels. Style the Ottoman separatists. What? Oh, this is so ridiculous. I think I'll take over all my Persian lands. It's bullshit. Oh wow, just suffer a massive attrition tech. Okay, what tech can we take? Diplo tech, sure. a steel mats. Yep, he do. Let's go kill these stupid Ottoman separatists. Leading by example, gains one stability, that's helpful. I don't have a choice, I have to kill those stupid separatists before they cause more problems. Movement speed plus 10%, that's nice. Oh, excellent. Let's go smash that army once more. Let's make them really not want to be in this war now. Consolidated regiments. Let's kill an agent, that's nice. This should be an easy fight for us, yep. No problem, 5 more war score. Unfortunately, it's literally impossible for me to chase them down. But, let's see, what would Ottomans give me now? Still not all your money. Okay, how much money will you give me? 160. I could just take this peace right now, take all this land. I can't really take much more than this without causing a lot of people to be upset with me. Let's be realistic. I mean, if I take one more province, let's say Konya. Actually, I could take one more province. I mean, if I do that, Konya, I can burn all this down, which would be good. Let's make sure you guys aren't upset with me. So, okay, everything is over here is fine. Hey, Najid, you're helping out, sorta. Oh, excellent, the Najid separatist has gone over to Oman. Yes, Oman, go deal the separatists for me. Actually, looks like he's got beaten by separatists. That's fine as well. Hopefully Najid will help me unseize these provinces back and deal these stupid rebels for me. If I'm lucky. But over here, okay, let's have a look at a peace deal again. If I take no money from you, I can take Konya, or just a little bit more war score. And let's say if I take Karaman as well, how much value is that? 17. Oh my god, 17. That's fine as well, but that will cost me a huge amount because the demand exceeds war score. Okay, I'm going to sit on this for a little bit while I let them recover. That might be the plan. We'll see. Man, I feel like I'm the one being taken advantage of here because they fully occupy that side and yet I'm the one beating up the army over and over. 7,000, wow. That's all the Ottomans have left. They have just that, 8.4k, that's an entire army because they got nothing on that side and this is all that's left on this side. I'm going to send my entire army over here and go deal with separatists. I'm going to ignore them for a little bit. Rebel crossing the border, yes I know. We have renewed a loan, whatever. Persian separatists, our own Persian separatists, yay. I feel so happy about that. We'll wait a couple months, see how this works out. Sire, refused to pay. Persian separatists, I know, I'm bound to work on that. Military leader has left us, is that a good leader? Nope, it's movement speed. The good leader is still here as well. Okay, I'm probably ready to peace you out, screw Karaman. I'll just take some of your money. Can I take Biga? If I take Biga, that'd be nice. I mean, if I don't take any of this and take these lands, the advantage of this is that then I will have full control of the coast from the get-go. And I will have effectively split Ottomans up into two halves. And then can I take any other land? Nope. Okay, let's do this. This will be our peace deal. So this means I'll have split your entire army in half. Next time round, I can move my army freely. I can take Ankara. I can take all these back forts pretty much for free next time round. Assuming that Europeans don't completely eat you up over there. Either way, I think this is pretty much the end of the Ottomans. I don't want to be in this war for much longer because I have to deal with my own rebellions. So let's send this peace offer off. Excellent. My Shah, Ottomans accepted our generous peace offer. Ottomans will cede. Whole bunch of stuff. What is this? Kosili, Hinduvindiga, Biga, and Bolu to a Karakun. They'll pay us 75 ducats and give me some inflation. I suffer a little bit of aggressive expansion, some prestige, and I gain power projection. Yep, screw you, Ottomans. And now they have no way of getting across. And guess what, Ottomans? I'm not going to give you military access. You want to get people across? Use your boats. Ha. No, that's not cruel at all. Okay, we've gained Kosi Valley against Genoa. Sure. Why? Are we actually born in Genoa now? Genoa. Ah, so yeah, I think this is Genoa, even though it's terra incognita. I mean, we can't see it. I believe that's Genoa right there. Funny. Oh, let's do this quickly. Burn into the ground. I mean, one bad thing about playing as a horde is that because you burn a lot of things to the ground, you end up with a lot of very terrible provinces. One extra missionary. Stupidly important. And let's take the next military take. Wow, do we actually beat them with inferior military? I mean, we're on 6. They're on 7. Yeah, we're wasting their assets despite the fact they have better military tech than us. And we can now build cannons. Yay. Okay, we have a second missionary now. Let's call this if we can. We can't. We'll call those two for now. And, yep, I know. And let's go convert Mush. Mush is, I believe, here. I'm actually starting to remember some of these places. We have a stupid amount of rebels about to fire. We are massively in manpower debt, as we always are. Let's make sure our banner leaders is in charge. Oh, hi, Venice. How you doing? Okay, don't care. Oh, also, let's finally peace out here. So what I'm going to do is not give Najit any land. Here's what I'm going to do instead. Karakun. Karakun. And this is actually better than giving them land directly. It's kind of silly that that's even a thing. It really shouldn't. But either way, this is all mine now. So, aha, too bad. Oman has a claim on this province. Well, too bad. You're still fighting against Ethiopia. That's hilarious. So, we take all this land. And, is that full annexation? Nope, you still have some land over there. Pay me war reps, even though I'm pretty sure you don't have any money left. And that's all I can get from you. Send that demand. Now, I don't actually want any of this land. Instead, I'm gonna burn it all down. Why does this matter? Because I get a point for it, and then, guess what? Hey Najid, my bestest of best buddies. Oh look, Armenia actually is down to 88% now. That's amazing. But Najid, I can pay off your debt, but I'm not going to. Instead, I'm going to grant you a whole bunch of provinces. I hope you like it. In fact, do you want some of your old provinces back? Because I don't want them. Like this stuff here, I don't want any of this. They're all three. Oh, I've already called it, haven't I? Don't. Oh well, that's okay. Najid. Najid. Oh, you guys want land. Of course you want land. Why wouldn't you want land? Najid. Grand Province. So, A.H. something. A.H. Kaf? Akaf? Akaf. There, you can have the land. Now, Kathiri. Kathiri. Okay. Grand Province to you. Mara. Mara. And you're gonna spend all the points. Grand Province, Kinder. And then, let's just double check. I think I'll keep one province for myself, and that'll be this one, Mocha. Why? So I can potentially declare war on whoever's on this side. Using tribal conquest, or probably the Holy Wars causes barely, which is actually pretty awesome. I like it. Najid, Grand Province. Aldroff. Yeah, I just turned all this into three development provinces. This is the only non-three development province. That's kind of funny. Okay, what am I doing? This is actually going up slightly. Nadran. Whoops. I keep misclicking away. They're liking us quite a bit. And the reason why this is better is because, you look at this, each time I do this, the liberty desire actually goes up. In fact, let me show you properly. What is this? Sana. When we will grant this to... No, we will grant them, Sana, the liberty desire will decrease by 1% and become 36%. The overextension will increase. Well, it's your overextension, not mine, so not my problem. Najid, Grand Province, Aden. And I will call this one ourselves. Ooh, we need one more rival, do we? Mamluks, no thanks. Poland, Venice, I don't really want to rival any of these. Muscovy, Poland. I don't want to fight Poland. I mean, they're so far away, they probably won't be relevant, but it will be at some point. We could fight Venice, I suppose. They could become our new rival, but I mean, how am I supposed to even declare war on Venice? Who are you allied with? The Knights and Ferrara, you're probably in a trade league. I don't want to fight Venice. I'll be honest, I don't want to fight Venice. I don't want to fight the Mamluks either. I wanted them to be my friend. That said, I do have to turn on them at some point, so I don't know. I mean, Mamluks has a massive army, don't they? They have 36,000 troops active. We have a grand total of 17,000, so that would be a very dumb idea to rival them. Instead, I don't know. Venice, they have a big navy. So we can't really attack at Venice anyway. We might be able to attack Muscovy at some point, but I don't really want to fight Muscovy. Problem is, if we don't do this, we're going to start losing power projection, so that'll be bad as well, because we need power projection to keep our Moloch points up. I mean, that said, we do burn things down for Moloch points, but still. Poland, Muscovy, Mamluks. I think out of anybody, we're most likely to attack Poland. Which, to be honest, means we're not really likely to attack Poland. I don't want to attack Poland. They are a potential good friend, but that said, they're kind of far away. And Hungary's in a way, so the good news about this is that I think let's go ahead and rival Poland. They will never attack us, I think. I mean, they basically have no reason to. Hungary's in a way, Moldavia's in a way. If we keep Silestria here to the Ottomans, we won't even share a border with them, so they have basically no reason to attack us. I think that's probably a good plan. I want to become friends with Muscovy, because no offense, Poland, Lithuania, but I think the Russians are cooler than you. Oh wait, that might actually insult some people. Either way, I think Muscovy will potentially grow much bigger than these two, especially since they didn't actually join a union together. Ha! Ottoman is stuck on this side now, that's funny. Okay, cool. Hey, Great Horde accepted peace with Muscovy. I can't speak. Great Horde will see Lower Don. Tambov, basically a whole bunch of places to Muscovy. Okay, great. I'm attacking into mountains. Well, I have to kill them anyway. Go ahead. I give the order. I don't have a choice. Military access from Genoa. Okay, I mean, this will effectively give Ottomans access, but hey, I mean, if you guys want to fight each other, be my guest. Yep, it's called Biga. Najid, you guys should love me right now. Yep. Armenia, they're actually pretty close to loving me, and then I can integrate them. Hopefully, once you've converted all these provinces. Which you still haven't. What are you doing, Armenia? Why aren't you converting this province? Is it because it's too big? That can't be the reason. That's annoying. Well, let's go kill these stupid separatists. I'm gonna take a bit of damage doing this. Quite a lot of damage, in fact. But I don't have a choice. I have to kill these separatists. Oh my god, you're going there as well? Oh wow. This is ridiculous. Back to fighting rebels. Oh yeah, tribes. You want stuff. So, what can I give you? Let's give you Trebizond. Let's give you Era's Income. And now you're happy. Yep, you're happy enough. Let's continue. Let's go kill these separatists in... Flatland. 1, 2, 3. 1, 4, 1. 1, 2, wait, what? 1, 2, 0. I must be seeing things or something. I keep saying 1, 2, 3 or like just saying 3 maneuver and they don't have 3 maneuver. What am I going on about? Oh wow, this is so ridiculous. Oh, hey Oman, thanks for helping me siege back my stuff. Great help, man. I mean, you got your own problems to deal with, but thanks, man. Very helpful. Wow, come on, stop losing so many troops. Kill these stupid separatists. We're down to 10k soldiers. This is such a joke. Oh wow, look at that general. At 4-2-1. Huh. Come on, Ajit. Get an army together and help me out here. 70. Okay, we're not going to get that for at least a little while. We could also start focusing. Am I focusing on anything right now? Yes, I am. On administrative. Okay, that's good, I suppose. Let's go kill this army. That's Oman's problem, technically, so I don't really care too much. Don't care. Okay, let's recall you. Ottoman Anatolia. Ottomans. That's funny. Hopefully in the next war, we'll simply take over the rest of Anatolia, or heck, we can actually jump over to Europe. That'd be good as well, because I want to make a foothold in Europe. Especially across the strait if we can, because if we can get across the strait, it means we won't have to ever worry about naval superiority, which would be good. What's this? Oh, we have 3 diplomats. Ottomans hate me, naturally. You guys will not join a coalition against me, but let's approve with you anyway. You might, but you like me for now, and you will even give me an alliance. Will you vassalize? No, you won't. Cyprus, will you vassalize? No, you won't. How about you, Ramazan? No, you won't. Okay. How about you? Will you be my vassal? Oh, I own your cause, do I? Well, that's a real shame, because if I didn't own your cause, you would totally accept, too. Oh well, Hormuz, will you vassalize? Will you be my vassal? I own your cause. Oh yeah, that's right, I attacked you over here, didn't I? Wait, what? These used to belong to Hormuz? Huh, okay, sure. Let's merge this army together. Thanks, Oman, you're the best. Best ally ever. I like my stupid vassals. Oh, come on. Stop losing. Beat him up. Yeah, beat him up. Go for it. Wow, you're rolling so terribly. I mean, this was pretty much a foregone conclusion battle anyway, but you are rolling so terribly. I get it, he has a better general than us, but still. Okay, just one rebellion over there left, and then we have to deal with Karakun tribes. You gotta be kidding me. Why are you tribesmen rebelling as well? Ah, I'm going crazy. Okay, let's quickly get all this stuff back. So we can at least close off this problem, then we'll quickly get the Persian lands back. And then, I guess we gotta deal with the freaking tribes. We are losing money like crazy. Bold fighter land needed a shock. Oh, that's good. We need to get another leader at some point then. Let's take advantage of that. 96 now. Great. And Najid. My diplomatic reputation is terrible, apparently. Yep, I know. Probably because my army's getting smaller as well. That doesn't help matters. I'm going to assume Oman will deal these rebels for me, right? Because they're kind of ravaging Omanian lands right now. Hungary accepted peace with the Ottomans. Oh, look, Ottomans. Hungary is extending their tendrils into you. Ottomans will cede Silesia, Sofia, Vidin to Hungary. Give money. Great. I mean, I would have liked to stay in that war, but I simply didn't want to keep fighting there because I had my rebellion problems. Come on, Oman, please kill those rebels for me. I don't want to have to fight those rebels. I can't afford it. Military access from Naxos, okay. Military access from Venice, okay. I mean, not my enemy or anything. I'm really hoping Muscovy. Oh, look, you're so close to me now. Alliance? Still nope. Okay, we gained... I think it was this one here. No, why did I call this province? I don't want this province. Oh, well. Oh, well. Oh, we have a fort here. Let's get rid of this fort. We'll get rid of this. No, let's mothball this fort. I'll mothball this fort. Do I want to get rid of this fort? Maybe. Because it is a grassland fort, which makes it more useful than that fort. That said, this fort is right over the straits, which makes it itself very useful. Let's keep both these forts for now. I mean, I possibly should have kept this fort as well over here, but I don't want to pay for it. Okay. Okay, let's send you over here. How many is in this army? Mostly zero regiments. Okay, let's try organize this a bit. This is messy. You, go here. You. You two, go here. You two, go here. You two, go here. And this last one. Okay, you go there, and you go there. There we go. Everybody's a job to do. And we'll go kill those afterwards. Najid, okay. I do have to integrate Nigeria soon before they become rebellious. Conversion completed. Great. Although, hopefully they won't. They really shouldn't. All the land he gave them was complete crap. Okay, let's convert more. Oh, that's why I was losing money. Oh, hey, we're actually making positive money if I wasn't converting so much. That's hilarious, actually. Let's go and convert. Let's see. Oh, okay, we can't do Hinterwindgar yet, but let's convert one of these places. Say, Amsia. Amsia? What the heck? Oh, Amsia? No. A-M-A-S-Y. What the heck? I don't even know. Turkish culture. Ooh, can we accept Turkish culture? Because a lot of this here will be Turkish, won't it? Yep, all of this here is Turkish, in fact. We want to accept Turkish culture, definitely. Can we? It's a question. 2 out of 2. Nope, we cannot. Because Turkish culture is going to quickly become one of the biggest culture groups in our empire. Oh well, that's unfortunate. How about let's go convert this place instead? Asalia? Asaliak? I'm sorry how much I butcher these names. I know I do it, but it's all. It's just that I don't actually know how to pronounce them, so, you know. That's my excuse, and it's actually, I think in this case, it's a quite legitimate excuse, because I have very little knowledge about this area of the world. Both of the language, and for most part of history, too. I mean, I got some rough ideas of the history of this area, but for the most part, I don't know. Okay, Persia... What do you call that? Okay, I know. Ooh, are they actually coming for my capital? I hope not. I think they're actually coming for my armies. Blasphemy. Okay, a prominent outspoken government official recently transferred home from the diplomatic corps. Okay, whatever. Gain piety, lose piety. Let's gain some piety. Cool. Hungary has cancelled military access. Sure. Not my problem. But seriously, I've never seen Ottomans get beaten up this badly. This is rather unusual. Where are you going? Tabriz. Don't you dare siege down my capital. And that's actually very annoying that my capital's even on a freaking mountain. I don't like that. It makes things really awkward for me. But yeah, I actually siege down my capital. You stupid rebels! You're Persian separatists from Hormuz! What the hell are you doing siege down my capital? Oh wow. We still have Karakun tribes showing up soon as well. Are we ahead of military tech? By 10 years. Okay. Karakun tribes, please just go away. In fact, where is it? What? Here. Increase autonomy. How much do you want? If I accept, what happens? Oh my god, plus 30% in so many freaking places. That is insane. They gain 15 influence, which is not a big deal. I lose 20 prestige. Okay, what can I possibly do to reduce your rebellion size? Salia, okay, this place. Go away from here. What now? Samawa. Go away. There, no more tribe rebellions. Seriously, I just don't want to deal with them right now. I can't afford to deal with them. This is too much. Let's take all this back. I have to go stop them from taking my capital. In fact, let's have... Okay, I shouldn't need too many troops to take back the capital. Take out our army. So it's only 4k, so... But still, let's send as many people as possible. Just keep one army here and taking these provinces back. Anything else is about to show up? I think that's it, actually. Right? What are you talking about? What do you mean they will start rebellion soon? No, they won't. Okay, good. You guys. That's 4.2k. I can't believe it's sieging my capital. That's ridiculous. We'll go to war with Persia soon, but not yet. I can't. Not until these rebels are dealt with. And not until I get some freaking manpower. Look at this, we're negative 31k again. Mostly to Ottomans? Nope. Mostly to freaking rebels. Story of this campaign. It's kind of silly, really. Oh, I don't actually have a general in the army. Shit. Well, hopefully they won't take my capital too quickly. It shouldn't. It really shouldn't. Should expire of Ireland. Great. Free advisor slot. We are still losing money, so nope. I would love to. We could definitely do the Malik points. Karakion's taken back Ardakan. Great. Balochistan is not renting out to Timurids. Okay. Timurids are getting completely eaten up by the Uzbeks. Which is fine, because Uzbeks are my allies. Teutons accepted peace. Teutons no longer exist. Cozy Valley against Yemen is gone because Yemen no longer exists. Instead, I don't actually know who replaced them, to be honest. Someone over here. I actually have no idea who. That's interesting. Karakuns occupy that. Great. Okay, let's bring the troops together. In fact, you take that back. 8k should be plenty to take back our capital. We will have the terrain bonus. Should be an easy fight. And we can ignore rebels for now. For now. Okay, merge everyone. We have 8,000 cavalry. Great, let's kill them. Which general is this? Less shock damage, good. Improve relations with Amazon. You can come back. Okay, let's finish this fight and then we can... I don't know, think about it, because time's basically up. In fact, it's stripping up 10 minutes ago, so after this fight, I'll end the episode. Nice and easy. Okay, so we have beaten back the Ottomans once again. I think they're basically done for this campaign. They're no longer going to be a threat ever. So, I don't know. We'll have to see what happens next time, because we'll either attack Persia or something. But either way, I hope you enjoyed this episode, and I will see you next time for more This Is Persia with me. Until then, see you later.